my dear students, welcome back to another video with Miss Laura. Today, we will read together another interesting story. It is called, let's take a look. It is called The Group of Seven, okay? So before to read, we are going to do our vocabulary for the reading, okay? So we have, repeat after me, please, alliance. Alliance is alianza. Landscape. Landscape. That is paisaje. That's right. Look at this amazing landscape. We have colorful. Colorful. As you can see here, right? Many colors. Impressionistic depictions. Impressionistic depictions. Representaciones impresionistas. Paintings. Paintings, as you have here, when you go to the museum, you can see a lot of these, right? These paintings are amazing. Principles, principles, that is, that means principios. Decades, decades, décadas. Purpose, purpose, your propósito, right? Broad-minded people, broad-minded people, personas de mente abierta. That's right. So those were our words for the vocabulary. Here we have, look at the picture. It says the group of seven. And what do we have there on the wall? What do we have? Paintings. That's right. So let's read together what is it about. Okay? The group of seven. Let me put it bigger. It says, what is the group of seven? Is it an alliance of countries? Is it a rock band? It is actually a group of Canadian painters that is just as famous in the Canadian art circles as many as any junior award winning rock star. So they are famous. These Canadian painters are really famous, okay? Obviously in the Canadian art circles. Here we have, in 1920, McDonald, Jackson, Arthur Lismer, Frankie Carmichael, Lawrence Harris, Barley, and Frank Johnson formed a club. So these seven men, all of them were painters, and they formed a club. It's a who were drawn to the rugged landscape. So they were focused on landscapes, okay? Were specifically of the Canadian Shield. So they were focused on the landscapes of the Canadian Shield, okay? So let's continue. The vast stretch of ancient rock around Hudson Bay, the blankest match of Eastern and Central Canada in a horseshoe shape. Their colorful and impressionistic depictions of the rocks. So look, their colorful and impressionistic depictions of the rocks, the trees, and lakes of this landscape were infused with spirit and power, giving their work a unique and innovative style. So you see, they had an innovative style and it was a unique work, okay? In the beginning, critics scoffed, critics laughed, ha, 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 at their work. And this happens usually when you want to start something, right? There are many critics and they can say whatever that they want, but always you have to focus on your things. You have to focus on what you want, okay? Let the critics talk. But it happens, right? So these painters, the seven Canadian painters, they were focused on their work and they became famous. Because even if the critics were laughing, ha, 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 at their work, because everybody starts in that way, okay? Now, however, their paintings, as well as those of Tom Thompson, who died. Tom Thompson died before. My goodness. He died before the group was formed. Okay. Are some of the world's highly prized Canadian art. So they are very famous. Okay. Maybe at the beginning, they didn't get that popularity, but now because of their effort, they continue and they focus and they show to them that they have an innovative style. Now they became famous, okay? For this artist, the rugged country inspired them, okay? The rugged country inspired them, not only with respect to their paintings, but also with respect to life. They develop a set of principles or sentiments that they call Angle Maxims, which is a reference to Algonquin Park, where they often work. Even today, decades later, it is interesting to see how these sentiments reflect the collective nature of Canadians. The great purpose of landscape art is to make us at home in our own country. Okay? So that was a purpose for them, right? To make you feel that you are at home, okay? Even if you are in your country, they wanted to show, to transmit that. Getting the habit of looking at the sky, it is the source of light and art. Canada consists of 3,500,523 square miles of mostly landscape. Imagine! So they have this amount of square miles in landscape. It is apparently intended to be the home of broad-minded people. A critic is known by the company he keeps. Coordinate your ideas so that you are advanced by all of them. The more you know, the less you condemn. The blue glasses or prejudice spoil all color schemes. You see? Interesting reading about the group of 77 painters, Canadian painters, that they create their own style, their own innovative style, focus on the landscapes of Canada, right? And they did these impressionistic depictions of the rocks, streets, and lakes, everything related to the landscape, okay? So now, what do we have to do here? We have to circle for true sentences, T for true and F for false. It says, the group of seven was a group of Canadian painters. That's right, that is true. Yes, remember they formed, these seven people formed a club and they were Canadian and all of them were painters. Arthur Lismer and Jackson painting a scene of the Arctic lands. Nothing about anything about that. Okay? It mentioned that they were focused on the landscapes of Canada Shield. Okay? False. The Canadian Shield has a rugged landscape that attracts the group of seven. Yes. That's why they had these impressionistic depictions of the trees, the rocks, the lakes. Okay? They attract to the group of seven. That is true. Tom Thompson was also an impressionist painter. Yes, that's true. Even if he died before the club was formed, he was an impressionist painter as the other seven. The Canadian Shield covered much of the country's northern wilderness in a horseshoe shape. No, that's false because it just covered the easterns, okay, the eastern. That's false. Here we have, I will put it bigger so you can see it, okay, clearly. B, quote one or two sentences from the passage, from the reading, to support each of the following sentences, okay? So we are going to support our ideas, support these sentences, okay? At the start of the group of seven's career, their painters were not valued at all. Yes. Where is it? Here. Remember that at the beginning, Some critics were laughing, okay? It was not, their paintings, the paintings of the group of seven were not that famous at the beginning, but later it was, right? What is the supporting idea here? In the beginning, critics scoffed at their work. Okay, so here we have, in the beginning, critics scoffed at their work. Number two, the Canadian Shield influenced both the group of seven's work and their approach to life. This is here. For these artists, the ragged country inspired them, not only with respect to their paintings, but also with respect to life. Okay, that is the one to support here. So we will copy, for these artists, okay, the ragged country inspire them not only with respect to their paintings, not only with respect to their paintings, but also with respect to life, but also with respect to life, period. Okay, it say here, a vast open environment is connected to an openness of mind. Here is it. Canada consists of 3,500,523 square miles. Yes, here is the one who supports. Canada consists of 3,500,523 square miles of mostly landscape. Okay, it is apparently intended to be home of broad-minded people. That's right. And the last one, knowledge breeds acceptance. Miss here, the more you know, the less you condemn. Here we have capital letter, the more you know, the less you condemn. The less you condemn. Okay, so that is all. We completed our reading about the group of seven, the seven people, the seven Canadian painters, right? So here we have a homework. Okay, so you will write 9 sentences in your grammar notebook using the vocabulary of the group of seven. So this vocabulary that is here, you will write sentences. You're going to write sentences with alliance, landscape, colorful, impressionistic depictions, paintings, principles, decades, purpose, broad-minded people. Okay, so that's all. That is the homework about. So see you in the next videos. Goodbye, take care.